I know not what course others may take, but as for me, give me liberty or give me death.
It took but a few moments for these famous words to be spoken, but they were so powerful, they inspired people to want to fight for their freedom. But who said those great words and why? Let's go back in time. Before the United States existed as a country, when people lived in the 13 colonies, the colonists had come from Great Britain, which included England. Even though an ocean separated the colonists from their rulers, it didn't stop the king and his lawmakers from telling them what to do. Colonists were tired of following unfair rules that they had no part in making. One such person was Patrick Henry. He didn't like the king at all. He wanted the colonists to form an army to protect their freedom or risk losing it forever. On March 23, 1775, Patrick Henry, among other leaders, including two future presidents, gathered in a church in Richmond, Virginia, to discuss their growing troubles with Great Britain. Now, let's listen in on the debate.
I'm tired of following the king's rules, rules that I had no part in making.
So we'll go to the king and talk about this peacefully. He will hear us.
Patrick Henry did not agree. He knew from experience that the colonists had tried to work out their problems with the king before, but they were not heard. Patrick Henry didn't understand why things would be different this time.
I have but one lamp of experience. I wish to know what there has been in the conduct of the British ministry for the last 10 years to justify those hopes.
Henry's right. The king's not interested in talking. He's only interested in taking.
The king's powerful army was already in the colonies. In Patrick Henry's eyes, the king was not looking for peace.
They are meant for us. Sir, we have been trying that for the last 10 years.
So what is your idea, Mr. Henry? That we reach for our guns so that we can fight the most powerful army in the world?
But Mr. Henry believed it was better to prepare now for battle than hope for things to get better. And more importantly, he believed they could beat the British Army.
They tell us, sir, that we are weak. But when shall we be stronger? Will it be the next week or the next year? Will it be when a British guard shall be stationed in every house? Gentlemen may cry, peace, peace, but there is no peace.
Patrick Henry knew that it was better to fight and die for liberty or freedom than to live as prisoners under an unfair king. His great words forever changed history.
I know not what course others may take, but as for me, give me liberty or give me death.
Moved by Patrick Henry's words, the men in church that day voted to form its own army. And just 1 month later, in April of 1775, colonists in Massachusetts fired the first shot against English soldiers in what is now known as the Revolutionary War. To this day, Patrick Henry's words sound out like a trumpet heard by freedom-loving people everywhere.